terms that you would get from Finkel calculations. This theory is, of course, well, apart from being interesting, just as describing the structure of the theory, may also be useful for certain kinds of applications in which non-leading terms in the curvature become important. I won't say very much about that. Just to set the scene, notation, remind you that type 2B theory has the following set of fields, the scalars, which I'm calling omega, particularly in this talk, the complex scalar sits in a coset, and the coset being SR2RV1, and then there's a set of bosonic and fermionic fields, and in particular, they carry a charge, a U1 charge, which is associated with a U1 charge, except the U1 in the coset. And then most importantly, in string theory, and in fact in quantum supergravity, we know that continuous SL2R has to be modded out by the SL2Z, has to identify the scalar fields under the SL2Z. And that follows when string theory, it's explicit in the theory, the theory is only invariant under this discrete symmetry. In quantum supergravity, we know it because there's an anomaly in that U1 current, which is consistent with this particular coset. I want to discuss higher derivative terms beyond the classical supergravity terms. And those are... So in general, there'll be some product like alpha force or some function like Lambda Zeta Zeta, there'll be some power of those fields in the theory, which I call D, and that'll be characterized by having a U1 charge U and having some dimension delta, which is related to N, where N was the power of alpha prime that we're talking about. As I just said, the theory is invariant under this discrete SL2Z duality symmetry, which means that when you write down a generic term in the action involving this combination D, then since D carries a non-trivial U charge, which is a generic SL2Z transformation will transform D non-trivially, so that the coefficient function has to transform correspondingly in order to make the whole thing invariant, and so F has to be some sort of modular form. In the notation I'm using, it has to be modular form which transforms with a phase, the phase being determined by U, and so it has to have equal and opposite holomorphic and anti-holomorphic weights and transform in this manner. So these coefficient functions F contain a huge amount of information about the particular terms in these series. And the question is, how are the F constrained by supersymmetry? So let me check. The F is not holomorphic, and the situation. So the situation here is very different from examples with less